From the Goa you never thought existed to a journey you would never dream possible. As a matter of fact, it had never been attempted before until Amir Bashir and Nalla Muthu decided to just do it.
This is a 44 Magnum, the most powerful handgun in the world, and it'll blow your head clean off. Now, you gotta ask yourself one question. Do I feel lucky? Well, do you, punk?
This was once dacoit country. Here, bandits robbed villagers, held up trains, and fought gun battles with the police and rival gangs. Today, Chambal is part of folklore, immortalized in several Bollywood productions. This is India's answer to the wild American West. One look at the terrain, and you know that Clint Eastwood would have felt at home here. Eastwood would have used a horse. We are using a much slower mode of transport, a raft. And we've been told this is the first time anyone is paddling down the Chambal. I hope it won't be the last. Vaibhav Kala and Solil Paul are my guides. JD, whose speciality you'll soon discover, is also accompanying us. We are starting our journey at the confluence of the Chambal and the Parvati rivers. Because we wanted an early start, we set up camp the previous evening. Besides, the nearest hotel is 2 hours away at Savai Madhopur. A rafting expedition on the Chambal should cost you ₹1,500 per person per day, all inclusive. Overlooking the confluence is an old Shiva temple that has been witness to the tumultuous history of the Chambal. Any number of battles and wars have been fought in this region over the centuries. The surprising thing is that nobody, including the village headman, knows how old the temple is or who built it. There is so little information on the Chambal for the potential tourist that you feel like an explorer of sorts.
Chambal has seen a lot of wars between and people crossing the river from.
Before hitting the water, I met Fateh Singh Rathore, who knows the area like the back of his hand and is writing a book about it.
The Sindhias has fought wars across, like, you know, coming to Rajasthan and Rajasthan.
So it is a scary place.
It's not very scary place, but they are not really, because actually...
not very scary.
But it is scary.
The river is so wide that you're left pretty disoriented. This mass of water forms the boundary between Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan. You see very few settlements along the banks, which is a little strange, because this is the only perennial river in an otherwise arid region.
It's a very calm, slow-moving river. At times, you can't even figure out which way the river is moving. But it's no smooth sailing. You have to paddle really hard to make your way through. What do you say, Kala?
A powerful motor boat could have been an option, but they make too much noise and travel too fast. The idea is to slow down, and nothing travels slower than a raft. Journey in March. We had thought that this would be a pleasant month. We were dismayed to find that it was much warmer than we had anticipated.
His bottom scratches, he gets into the grass like the animals.
It's really hot, huh?
It's time to introduce you to JD, a happy-go-lucky kayaker. He's the grandnephew of Tenzing Norgay. Remember the guy who first climbed Everest with Edmund Hillary?
The river is supposedly a gharial sanctuary. We haven't seen a single one. Instead, we've seen children swimming in the river. I think I'll also go in for a dip.
What better way to beat the heat?
Moon, river.
Late in the afternoon, we came across a bridge connecting the states of Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan. It was the first and only sign of civilization we had seen in a long time. Taking a cue from it, we decided to halt for the night. A raft was a novelty. No one had seen anything like it before. We had lots of eager helpers. JD tried to make friends with some of the onlookers, but his charm didn't work. My arms and back were a bit sore after a long day of rowing, but good old JD, who seems to have limitless energy, helped me loosen up.
Yes. 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 No! This man gives a mean massage. If you want one, do write to me. Yes. Yes.
The river was teeming with fish. We tried every trick to catch a few, or catch one for that matter, but didn't succeed. Peeved at our incompetence, Vaibhav and I took a walk in the fields instead. Chambal for the locals is as holy as the Ganga. Ancient temples on the banks, holy dips in the morning, even their herds join in. Locals here wash their hair with what's called chikni mitti.
This is the local shampoo. It adds body to your hair and keeps it really soft. I plan to market it soon.
The people here use old country boats to cross the river. Leave alone getting across, how these boats stay afloat is beyond me. This is where the Chambal joins the Banas, and it's a picturesque spot with a nice sandy beach. Although there are plenty of fish around, we haven't been able to catch any. We have, however, managed to can some. The still waters of Chambal are ideal to learn kayaking. Lots of practice and expert advice will help me go a long way in becoming a pro. Maybe someday.
I guess we didn't need this after all.
So whether you prefer the smooth, straight and narrow, or the rough and ever so slightly dangerous, the great escape is always on hand. Goodbye.